Nanaimo, North Cowichan.
Madam Speaker, this government has been quite willing to ensure that its appointees have the help of the very best legal minds in British Columbia. In fact, they have indemnified at least six employees for legal assistance in interviews with the other special prosecutor's investigation. And while I'm reminded of the $6 million in legal bills the government paid two of its other former political aides, I want to focus on Mr. Gratis. Honourable Speaker, my question is to the Attorney General. Are taxpayers picking up Mr. Gratis's legal bills?
Madam Attorney.
Madam Speaker, as the member knows, and as I've said often in this House, the matter of indemnity is outside of the political process, which I think is exactly where we would all want it to be. It's in the hands of senior civil servants. I cannot comment on an individual case. What I can say, though, is when there is a criminal charge, if there has been an indemnity granted and there's a conviction, then the indemnity is paid back to government.
Member for Nanaimo, North Cowichan, on a supplemental.
Well, perhaps the minister wasn't in this House the last time BC Liberal political staffers went to court, that being Mr. Bassey and Mr. Virk, who pled guilty, and taxpayers were stuck with a $6 million bill. Honourable Speaker, taxpayers deserve better. My question is for the Attorney General. If Mr. Gratis is found guilty, will taxpayers again be stuck with the bill, or will we get our money back?
Madam Attorney.
Madam Speaker, whether or not an indemnity is granted is up to senior civil servants. As I said, it's not a political question. If an indemnity is granted, and again, speaking very much in the general, because the specifics are not before me, nor are they before this House, but speaking very much in the general, if there is a criminal conviction and there has been an indemnity, then the indemnity must be paid back.